Morning flies, and welcome back to the early bird. I'm your host, Griffin Yarmaloff. Alongside me, as always, is the man, Mr. Shea Curry.
What's up, all my twins out there?
We have a great show for you tonight. Can we dim the lights really quickly? Can we dim the lights? I want to get serious for a second. Do you know what date is, Shay?
Thursday?
Oh, no, it's Friday! Oh! Friday! It's a great show. We have a Friday movie rant for y'all. Let's get hype and roll that amazing intro. So I was going to do the Monday movie rant on Monday, as the name implies, but I've not been given the opportunity or the spotlight to do it yet. So here we go with another Friday movie rant. I should mention, I've edited the script for this rant since Monday's show. In the original rant, I told you about The Notebook, how it rained more tears than the Amazon jungle, how Ryan Gosling was just okay and really bad at acting sad, but deep down he already is. I was going to tell you about The Great Gatsby, how swift the cinematography was and the rapid pace is extraordinary for encapsulating the entire novel in a film that was beneath 3 hours. Tobey Maguire and Carey Mulligan were extraordinary, but neither topped the performance of Leo as the Great Gatsby. I was going to tell you about the new Netflix movie, The Power of the Dog, that hopes to place itself into the top spot for Oscar contention. And then I was going to tell you about how this movie stunk, and it was a huge letdown in my opinion, and that Benedict Cumberbatch should never be let in a Western ever again. But of course, that was all I was going to say before I got tickets last night to the premiere of Steven Spielberg's newest masterpiece, West Side Story. This movie is a hit and gets my absolute full approval. Its recreation on the big screen with fantastic cinematography, set design, and acting, primarily by Rachel Zegler and Ariana DeBose, both of whom should win Best Actress and Best Supporting Actress, respectively. But also, shout out to Anzel Egort for an amazing performance as well, which will surely throw him into contention for Best Supporting Actor. This movie didn't miss a beat. It was well-rounded, contained a nicely packed, condensed Spielberg dialogue that doesn't necessarily serve you the plot on a silver platter, but anyone with eyes can pick it up if they pay enough attention. This is why Spielberg is one of the greatest directors of all time. He makes movies for semi-dumb people. It's easy to understand and always fantastically overpriced, well-rounded piece of work. And West Side Story is no exception. West Side Story, 10 out of 10. I highly recommend it. And now, live in the studio with the pledge, is Noah Albright. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Noah. Anyways, Flyers, that is unfortunately all for today's episode of The Early Bird. Remember, if you want to watch this episode of The Early Bird or Fire News again, as well as watch any episode you missed, or phone our show to make an announcement in front of the entire school, you can find that all in our Instagram bio at Freemium High Studios. It's Friday, people. Get excited. There's tons of good movies coming out. I highly recommend going out to the theaters, to AMC even, to watch some of these amazing movies. I'm sure going to spend my entire weekend there. But make sure you get those tickets early, though, because the early bird gets the worm. Have a good weekend.
The red-nosed reindeer.